Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-146 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is determine the total axial and bending strain energy in A992 steel beam. Area is 2300 square millimeter and I is 9.5 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter power 4. So you can see this is the beam. There is a pin support at this point, clear, and there is a roller support at this point. The horizontal force is 15 kN and there is a distributed load of 15 kN per meter over a length of 10 meter. So you have to determine the total axial and bending strain energy. So we will find the axial strain energy and we will find the bending strain energy, and then we will sum these two to get the total strain energy due to bending and axial. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you remove this roller support, so you will be having a reaction force. Let this will be reaction force will be R. Let this is your 0.2, so it will be R2Y. And if and this support, pin support is the point here is 1. So if you remove this pin support, so you will be having a vertical reaction force which is equal to R1Y. And there will be horizontal reaction which will be R1x. So we'll find this R1x, R1y and R2y by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to zero and force in this direction is taken as positive. So you can see one force which is 15 kN is in positive direction and the second one is R1x that is in negative direction, their sum must be equal to 0. So I will write 15 minus R1x is equal to 0. So from here you will get R1x will be equal to 15 kN. Now we'll find in another reaction R1y and R2y by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all movement about point 1 is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise movement as positive. So you can see there is a distributed load when converted into point load, so it will be act at the middle of this beam and the magnitude of this point load will be 1.5 into perpendicular distance is 10 and that will be equal to 15 kN and that will act at a half of this total length which is 5 meter, okay, on either side. So this will be 5 meter and this will be also 5 meter. Now apply this equation. So about this point one, the one moment will be 15 kN into perpendicular distance is 5 and that is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I will write 15 into 5 and that is minus. The second moment is due to this R2y and perpendicular distance is 10 and this is producing counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I will write R2y into 10 is equal to 0. So what we will get is minus 75 plus 10 R2y is equal to 0. So from here you will get 10 R2y is equal to 75 and when you divide 10 on both sides, so you will get R2y will be equal to 7.5 kN. Now you have R2y, so you can also get R1y by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0 and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see one force is R1y and plus R2y minus 15 will be equal to 0. So R1y is not known plus R2y is 7.5 minus 15 is equal to 0. So again from here you will get R1y will be also equal to 7.5 kN. Now you have all these forces. So what we are going to do is that we will take any section in the beam. So you can either take x in this direction or x in this direction. Both will give you the same thing. So what we are going to do is that we will cut the beam over here and we will take the distance x from this. So this will be, and we will draw the free body diagram. So let me draw the free body diagram. Let this is the beam. Clear. So you can see at this point we have 15 kilonewton load, axial load 15 kilonewton. At this point, this is your point 2. At this point you have vertical force which is R2y, that is 7.5 kilonewton. Clear. The total length of this beam where we have cut it is x. So this is x. And when you cut it, so you will be having a shear force V and you will be having a moment. Clear? So moment will be like this. Okay. This will be the moment. And you can see you have a distributed load over this beam. And this load is 1.5 kilonewton per meter. So when converted into a point load, so it will be equal to 1.5 multiplied by x, and it will act at a distance of x by 2 from either side. So this distance will be x by 2. Now this is point O. So we will apply equation of equilibrium. So what will be the equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moments about point O is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. Now remember that there is also a normal force that will act in this direction, N. Clear? So we'll find this N as well. Clear? So we will apply first this equation of equilibrium. Sum of all moment about point O is equal to 0. So about point O, one moment is this clockwise moment, which is minus M. So I will write minus M. The other moment that is produced due to this 1.5x and perpendicular distance is x by 2, and this is also producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 1.5x into x by 2. And the last force that is producing moment about point O is this 7.5, and perpendicular distance is x, and this is producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 7.5 times x is equal to 0. So from here you will get this moment will be equal to 7.5x plus minus 1.5x square over 2. Okay, so what we are going to do is that you can see this force is in kilonewton, so you can also convert it into newton. So 7.5 into 10 to the power 3x minus 1.5 into 10 to the power 3 and x square over 2. So you can also take it, or you can use this one or this one. Okay, now what we are going to do is that we have find this moment. Clear? So we are going to find the horizontal force as well. So horizontal force can be obtained by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to 0 and force in this direction is taken as positive. So we will need only this n. N is minus n plus 15 is equal to 0. So from here n will be equal to 15 kilonewton. Now you can see you have a normal this axial load as well as you have moment. So first what we will do is that we will find the axial strain energy. So axial strain energy, I will write it for axial load. For axial load, we have strain energy axial is equal to integral of 0 to L n square dx divided by 2 AE, or this is also equal to, for single load, it is n square L divided by 2 AE. Clear? So you have all the values. N is 15 kilonewtons. So 15 into 10 raised to power 3 square. What about length of beam? Length of beam is 10 meter. So I will write multiply by 10 divided by 2 times area. Area in meter is given as, it is given in millimeter. So when you convert it into meter, it is 2300 into 10 raised to power minus 6. So 2300 into 10 raised to power minus 6. Multiply by E. E is not available. So what we will do is that we will go to the property tables and we'll find A992 steel. So here you can see that this is A992 steel and E value is 200 gigapascal. So note down this value, 200 gigapascal. So I will write here 200 into 10 raised to power 9 value. So when you solve this, you will get strain energy due to axial loading comes out to be 2.4456 joule. Okay, so this is the strain energy due to axial loading. Now what we will do is that we will find for bending. So for bending, we know that strain energy due to bending is equal to integral from 0 to L m square dx divided by 2 EI. Or this can be written as, if you take 1 over 2 E outside, so you will be having integral from 0 to L m square dx. Now you have the value of m, so you can just put it in that. M is this one. Clear? So you can put 7.5 into 10 raised to power 3 x minus 1.5 divided by 2 is 0.75 x square whole square into dx. Okay, now what you are going to do is that you will take the square. So strain energy due to bending is equal to 1 over 2 EI integral from 0 to L 7.5 square. 7.5 into 10 raised to power 6 square will be 56.25 into 10 raised to power 6 x square plus 0.75 whole square will give you 562.5 into 10 raised to power 3 x power 4 minus 2 times this term plus this term will give you minus 11.25 into 10 raised to power 6 x cube into dx. Clear? Now you can take integral and you can take the limit. So integral of this 56.25 into 10 raised to power 6 x cube over 3 and limit from 0 to L plus 562.5 into 10 raised to power 3 into x power 5 divided by 5 and 0 to L plus minus 11.25 into 10 raised to power 6 x power 4 divided by 4 and limit from 0 to L. As you can see, x start from 0 to x is equal to 10. So what we are going to do is that we will remove this L and we will write it over here 10. Okay, now when you put all the values, okay, 1 over 2 E is 200 gigapascal, so 200 into 10 to the power 9, and I is also available, which is 9.5 into 10 to the power minus 6. 9.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 multiply by 56.25 into 10 raised to the power 6 divided by 3 multiply by 10 minus 0 whole cube plus 562.5 into 10 raised to the power 3 divided by 5 into 10 minus 0 whole power 5 minus 11.25 into 10 raised to the power 6 over 4 into 10 minus 0 power 4. This will give you bending strain energy. Okay. And again, when you solve all this at last, you will get the bending strain energy UBI will be equal to 493.2 joules. Now you have both this clear, since we have been asked to find the total strain energy. So total strain energy will be equal to strain energy due to axial loading plus strain energy due to bending. So put the value 2.4456 plus 493.2 joules, and when you add these two, so what you will get is that you will get 496 joule, which is the answer of our this question. So this was all about this problem 14-146. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching.